Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is Time for Reflection, and our Time for Reflection leader this afternoon is Professor Joe Goldblatt, Chair of Edinburgh Interfaith Association.
Deputy Presiding Officer, distinguished members of the Scottish Parliament, and dear friends, good afternoon. As Chair of Scotland's oldest interfaith association that is celebrating our 35th anniversary of serving all faiths and none, I am indeed humbled and honored to be invited to address this august body. For 5,764 years, the Jewish people throughout the world have demonstrated great resilience despite our many challenges. When I was a wee bairn in my hometown of Dallas, Texas, my mother, born to a Jewish mother and a Catholic father, always erected in our home and decorated the largest and most beautiful Christmas tree in our neighborhood. We also lit our 8 Hanukkah candles. One night, the Hanukkah candelabra was a wee bit too close to the tree, and several branches started to burn. My mother screamed for help, and our papa ran into the lounge with a bucket of water, splashed the tree. He then turned to us and said, "Mama, it's a miracle, the burning bush." The story of Hanukkah this year begins on 7 December and demonstrates that my ancestors had faith in the Almighty by hoping that only 4 days of oil would last for 8 days to kindle their eternal light and their faith. The oil miraculously lasted, and we annually now spin the dreidel top, and when a child wins, they receive a golden wrapped chocolate coin. I have played this game with thousands of our Scottish primary school pupils as I teach them about Judaism, and they too must then decide whether to keep their treasure of the coin or share it with others who have greater need. In every classroom, when I invite them, they always donate. Bless our Scottish bairn. One child in a Scottish Borders primary school told me that he heard that Jews were often oppressed and punished. He then asked, "Can you ever just stop being Jewish?" I thought about this for a moment, and I asked him if he could ever stop being Scottish. He sprung up from his chair and he said, "Never!" You see, our precious individual identity, as you have debated many times in this chamber, is important to all of us. Therefore, as I discovered those many years ago, it does not only take a burning bush to make a miracle. There are miracles deep inside of us. And I wish all of you and yours a happy Hanukkah and Christmas that hopefully ushers in the miracles of greater love and peace among every one of us. Thank you. God bless you. God bless Scotland. Amen.